Hello! In this hopefully short episode of Finno-Greek Machining, we are going to balance this yarn ball winding machine. Well, it's quite out of balance. The counterweight I put there was not adequate, so it didn't balance it properly. Now let's do this in a proper way. So, well, this is the setup for trying to figure out how much weight, what mass should I put into this hole. I have removed the original counterweight, which was, well, actually this is too light. So we need a lot more into that one. But how much? Well, okay, I have here a piece of iron with a thread in it. Okay. And then I have this scale here. I switch it on. Now it's on. And then I can weigh this. So it tells me it's 341 grams. Okay. But what happens if I put this thread through this hole here? Like that. And when I pull this so that it so that this is level, about level. Now it's about level. So, and then I just put this thread around here so that it doesn't slip away. Now it tells me 217 grams. Okay, there is a difference. So let's take a note from those. So it was 270. And what was the original weight? 342. So 342 minus 270 equals to 125 grams. Okay, here is my original weight and it is 41 grams. Well, not even near. So we need 125 grams weight here. Well, it's a little bit less than half of this one. So I just make it nice looking first, then I weight it, and then I can measure the weight and how long is it, and then I know how much I need to remove from it to get it to the correct weight. Next thing, weight. Okay, so now I have done this. This is now faced properly on every side. It's very nice. And I have been weighting this, and this one now weighs 253 grams. And it is 25.7 millimeters long. So it's 9.844 grams per millimeter. Okay. So now our goal is 125 grams for this one. So we need to take away 128 grams. Yeah. To get the correct weight. So if we divide this 128 with this 9.844, we get quite exactly 13 millimeters. Hopefully not an omen. But yeah, 30 millimeters away and we should be in the correct way. And while I'm in the lathe, I will also put a hole here, a small hole for M5 thread. And since we are actually filleted with the bolt, it doesn't matter the hole, because it's the material is replaced by the screw. And then it is protruding something like 5 millimeters from here. So I can neglect that one, I believe. That's only probably half a gram, and that's not too much. So my measurements also can deviate that much. So now, taking away 13 millimeters out of that, this, and this is more than half of the length. So let's do that. It's again a lathe job. Oh yeah, now the balancer is here, and it became better as I expected. Well, it was easier operation than I thought, to measure the weight, and everything went as planned. That's a rare occasion when things happen that way. Anyway, now it's, well, I have a rubber mat here under. Because this is quite slippery, and now it's not so slippery, but still, earlier version was that when I was rotating it slowly, it didn't wobble, but now it doesn't wobble at all. So, well, success! So, this is how you balance things like this. You use just your common sense. And there you go. In the next episode of Finno-Greek Machining, I still don't know what to do. And therefore, I just say you, till then, bye!